They're all in line. We're ready for the start. They're off in the Breeders' Cup Million Mare Sprint, and Gamine and Serengeti Empress go at each other right away. These two and Serengeti Empress full tilt on the outside to grab the lead from Gamine, who's a half length off of her on the rail. It's four lengths back to Venetian Harbor and Speech, two to come dancing, four more back to Sconson and Bell's the One. The trailer up the backstretch is Sally's Curlin'. Let's see what this quarter is. 21.77 seconds. Serengeti Empress is the leader. John Velasquez now takes Gamine outside of her. Three quarters of a length behind as they move for the far turn. Speech and Venetian Harbor in close attendance, third and fourth. Come Dancing is fifth. She's got five lengths to make up as they race for the far turn. Another five to Bell's the One alongside of Sconson. Sally's Curlin is the trailer. Serengeti Empress rolling along through a 44.27 half. Gamine comes to take her on from the outside, and the two of them hook up at the top of the stretch. Speech is third. They're into the stretch. Serengeti Empress and Gamine head and head, nose and nose, coming to the final furlong. Sconson is trying to make progress up the rail, but Gamine has taken the lead. She has put away Serengeti Empress, and she's pulling away. Oh, what a super filly! Gamine and John Velasquez, they won it by six lengths on the wire, and they broke the track record. The final time was 120.20 seconds. What a performance, guy, by Gamine.
Another track record falls. Gamine lighting it up, going seven furlongs for the two-time Triple Crown winning trainer Bob Baffert. Another trip to a Breeders' Cup winner's circle.
I mean, that's what we wanted to see. It's like a good hitter and a good pitcher. They both took it to each other early. I thought it was a critical move that John Velasquez made. First of all, letting Gamine run fast enough, challenging Serengeti Empress the first eighth of a mile of the gate. Let's watch it when the gates open right here. That spreads the race out, and it strings about just like traffic going really fast. You can maneuver. So that tells me John's going to ease back after an eighth of a mile because they've already outrun the field. He has no chance of getting boxed in. Right in here, you'll see him let Serengeti Empress go just a touch. Now he moves outside. To me, that set up the whole race for Gamine. I'm not saying it made her win because she was pretty convincing, but that was a good move by John, and then he just takes it to her from there.
The question was, how much early speed would Gamine have coming off the mile and an eighth Kentucky Oaks? She'd never shown Serengeti Empress's type of early speed before in her career. She never had to, but she was just off of Serengeti's hip in the early part of the race through blistering fractions. She's right back to where she was when she won the Acorn by 18 lengths, when she won the test in that amazing performance. What a spectacularly talented filly this is.
The new dimension, Gamine had never passed another racehorse in her life. And today, she hooked up with Serengeti Empress, ran her down, and proved her worth for owner Michael Lund Peterson.